In the words of the great philosopher Francis Albert Sinatra, Theresa May is now in the autumn of her leadership years, and it's time for her to accept that she will not lead the Conservative Party into the next general election. But despite a difficult conference speech, the Prime Minister shouldn't go just yet, and nor should she be forced. She has two very important jobs to do. First, to order an autumn reshuffle that will get shut of her self-obsessed Foreign Secretary, but much more importantly, begin the process of her own replacement by reinvigorating the cabinet with potential leadership candidates from recent intakes. The timing of that leadership election will be governed by Mrs. May's ability to achieve her second task, to get the Brexit deal done, and if possible, with a shorter transition time than the one she's flagged. Brexit has smothered her government, and along with some self-harm, has left the domestic agenda wide open for the Labour Party and Comrade Corbyn. Far more worrying than the Prime Minister's shambolic speech, the Manchester conference showed that in the battle for ideas, the Conservative Party looked like followers, not leaders. And you just don't win elections from that position. We're on the back foot on Labour's territory, and on our own turf, the defence of capitalism, essentially what the Conservative Party is for, we've yet to mount a passionate defence. Meanwhile, the good work that my old boss David Cameron did to detoxify the Tory brand is being undone by the day. But the job of resetting the party, of showing that we do have answers to the questions that people are asking, and not just the under 40s, people of all ages, in all regions, that work must begin now. And the question, should it be a hard or should it be a soft Brexit, I suspect is not one that's dominating conversation in the pub. Theresa May is undeniably a hard-working, dedicated and patriotic politician. And whatever happens, her portrait will be on the staircase in Downing Street. But it's only by getting the Europe deal done fast and by beginning this work of renewal for the party that she loves that she will secure a legacy worthy of pride. If she doesn't, autumn may turn into a very long, very dark winter for the Conservatives, but also for the country.